Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to integrate 1 over square root of x minus the cube root of x. And here is the deal. You may want to try some substitution, maybe let u equal to the square root of x. But in that case, this will be bothering you, the square root and then the cube root. You know, they're not going to work out so well. Similarly, if you let u equal to the cube root of x, this right here will be bothering you as well. The expressions, they are not just going to cancel things out nicely, right? So, here is a much better strategy. As we know, this is a saying x to the 1/2 power, and this is a saying x to the 1/3 power. Why don't we look for the lowest common denominator of 1/3 and 1/2? And of course, that would be 6, right? So, what I'm going to do is, I will say let u equal to the 6th root of x, and you will see why. Anyway, let's get going from here. I need to get the dx, right? But I'm not going to differentiate this right here. It's slightly too hard. What I'm going to do is, I will just raise both sides to the 6th power so that I can get x equals to u to the 6th power. And then by looking at this equation, I can differentiate both sides and I can get the dx right away. And the derivative of u to the 6th power, it's just 6u to the 5, and of course, let's attach the du. And now you will see, I'm just going to plug in x being equal to u to the 6th power into this x and that x. And things will work out very nicely. So here we go. This is like saying the integral of 1 over. And let me just write the square root as the 1/2 power like this. But for the x right here, as we can see, this right here is what we said to be u to the 6th power. So I'm going to put that down right here. And we will be subtracting, same thing right here. This x is the same as saying u to the 6th power. But the cube root is saying raise this to the 1/3 power. And now you see the beauty of doing this, right? Because you will get whole number power. Anyway, dx though, don't forget to put this for that. So I will have to write down 6u to the 5 du for the dx. And this is going to be much cleaner, and of course, let's get going. Let's continue. This is a constant multiple, so let's go ahead and put that in the front. And we have the integral u to the 5th power. It has to stay inside of the integral. This is a variable, right? So let's put that on the top, u to the 5th power. And for the denominator, this right here is like saying u to the 6th power and then to the 1/2 power. You multiply the powers. So this is u to the 3rd power. And likewise, this is going to give us u squared du, like that. And that's pretty much it. And now, this is a much better rational function inside, right? And of course, right here, I can factor things out and cancel things out. Both of them, I can factor out u squared, and then I can get u minus 1. This top is u to the 5. Here we have u squared, so I can cancel this, and this becomes the 3rd power now. So, in another word, this is 6 times the integral u to the 3rd power over u minus 1. And of course, we are talking about the u world. Okay, so this is not that bad at all. Now, notice, this rational function, on the top the degree is 3, on the bottom the degree is 1. So we should do some long division. If you don't want to do long division, you can also do another substitution. Let w equal to u minus 1 maybe, and then you continue from there. I'm going to leave that to you guys though. Let's do long division. So, right here, I will just put down the long division part. So let me just tell you, u to the 3rd power over u minus 1 is equal to the following. I'm just going to put u to the 3rd power inside, and then the u minus 1 on the outside. And here we go. I need to have u squared, because u squared times u gives us u to the 3rd power. And u squared times negative 1 is minus u squared. And now subtract. This is 0. 0 minus minus becomes positive. Positive u squared. And then we continue. I need to have plus u, because u times u give me positive u squared, and then u times negative 1 is minus u. And then you do the same thing. And you see, this is 0 minus minus becomes positive. And lastly, I need to have a plus 1. So plus 1 times this is u, and then minus 1, and then inside the parentheses, and then in the end, 0 minus minus becomes positive 1. So that's pretty much the idea, right? And this right here is that saying we have u squared plus u plus 1, and the 1 is that saying plus 1 over u minus 1. Because this one is the remainder. And now I'm just going to put this right here for the integrand, and then we'll be able to integrate them term by term. So now we will be writing this down. We have the 6 right here and the integral, and this is the same as that. So I'll just put this down. U squared plus u plus 1, and then plus 1 over u minus 1. And let's put parentheses around this, and then of course we have the du right here. And we're finally ready to integrate. So let's go ahead and do that. Write the 6, and then open the parentheses for the result of integration. Integrating u squared in the u world, we get 1 third u to the third power. And then we continue. We add it with integrating this, we get 1 half u squared. Integrating this, we get just u. And then integrating 1 over u to the first power minus 1. This is going to give us the natural log, right? So we add it with natural log absolute value of u minus 1. And you should also check the derivative of the bottom, the derivative of u minus 1 with respect to u is just 1. So you technically will have to divide it by 1, but you know, doesn't really matter in this case. So this is pretty much it. And finally, we just have to go back to the x world. And that's all. So u, remember, it was equal to 6 root of x. And perhaps it's easier to look at this as power, so I'll write this as u equals to x to the 1 over 6. So here we go. I will first distribute the 6 into the parentheses and then do the substitution, right? So we do two things right here. 6 times 1 third, we get 2, and then u is x to the 1 over 6 power, and then we raise that to the third power. And then 6 times this is plus 3, and the u is x to the 1 over 6 power, and we raise this to the second power. And 6 times that is plus 6, u is x to the 1 over 6 power. And then 6 times that is plus 6 ln absolute value, u is x to the 1 over 6 power, and then minus 1 in the absolute value. Okay, this is pretty much it. But let's write this back in the radical notation. So finally, we see this is 2. Okay, 1 over 6 power times the third power, the powers together, is just 1 half. X to the 1 half power, it's the square root. So we have 2 times the square root of x right here. And then the next one is plus 3. Okay, 1 over 6 times 2 is 1 third. So that's the cube root of x in this case. And then the next one is plus 6, the 6th root right here, right, of x. And then we add this 6, and then the natural log, absolute value, and this is just the 6th root of x, pretty much. And then minus 1. Yeah, all this, we are done. Put a plus c, and box the answer, of course. Yes.